How did the universe form from nothing? According to science, the universe was created with a bang. A really big bang, that is. The Big Bang Theory, and no, we are not talking about the TV show, happens to be the most widely accepted theory for how the universe started. But how will it all end? That is a dark mystery. Stay tuned till the end to find out. According to the Big Bang hypothesis, the universe was created more than 13 billion years ago from a single, unfathomably hot and dense point known as a singularity. It didn't occur in a place that was previously there. Instead, it started the cooling and expansion of space itself. Why do scientists stand behind the Big Bang Theory? It explains a lot of what astronomers observe with telescopes on the ground and in space. It explains why, as space continues to expand, other galaxies are relocating away from us. It explains the little glow that can be seen throughout the cosmos. This glow is the warmth that the universe's creation left behind, which has since cooled to just a few degrees above absolute zero. It's a surprisingly effective and beautiful account of the origin of the observable universe, to put it perspective. The idea explains how the universe's lightest elements, which are hydrogen, helium, and lithium, were formed, from which all heavier elements were produced in stars and supernovas. Cosmic inflation, a Big Bang extension, even explains why the universe is so evenly constructed and how galaxies are scattered across space. What is cosmic inflation? What you are probably thinking, it's not the kind of inflation we're talking about. Many aspects of today's cosmos make sense if space had a rapid expansion early in its history. According to inflation theory, the universe expanded drastically a fraction of a second after the Big Bang, propelled by enormous amounts of energy contained inside space itself. Following the inflationary epoch, the universe continued to expand and cool, but at a much slower rate. Inflation immediately stretched out space, making it exceedingly uniform. However, space is not entirely homogeneous. During inflation, little changes in the density of matter existent in the very early universe were massively amplified. These density variations eventually gave rise to the universe's large-scale structure, which includes huge sheets, bubbles, and clusters of galaxies. Well, now that we know how it all started, the big question remains, how will the universe end? The Big Bang Theory does not specify whether the universe will continue to expand and cool or whether it will eventually contract to another super-hot singularity, possibly resuming the entire cycle. The qualities of two unknown substances known as dark matter and dark energy are likely to determine the eventual fate of the universe. Further research into both may tell whether the cosmos will end in fire or ice. Earth, the rest of the solar system, stars, galaxies, and interstellar gas account for just around 1/6 of the universe's mass. Scientists can observe the impacts of the remainder of the universe's mass, known as dark matter. Its presence in galaxies causes them to revolve faster than if only normal matter were there, and high concentrations of it bend light from a long distance. However, its nature is unknown. Dark matter could be made up of elementary particles that were produced in the Big Bang but have yet to be identified on Earth. The search for these missing particles is one of the reasons physicists desire to develop more powerful particle accelerators. Something even more mysterious than dark matter is a force known as dark energy. It's not science fiction. Observations of distant supernovae show that space is saturated by dark energy, which pushes objects apart in the same way that two positive electric charges repel one another. This enigmatic substance, which accounts for more than 70% of the universe's energy content, may be tied to the energy that generated inflation. However, nothing is understood about dark energy or how it affects matter today. Explaining it may necessitate completely new notions of space and time. Astronomers staring through telescopes are looking back in time. They view the Andromeda Galaxy, our nearest major galaxy, not as it is today, but as it was more than 2 million years ago, because that is how long it takes light from the galaxy to travel across space to Earth. Other galaxies are significantly more distant in both space and time. The Hubble Space Telescope can observe galaxies more than 13 billion years old that formed just after the Big Bang. The cosmic microwave background, a faint glow left over from the Big Bang, has been observed, which helps to paint a picture of what the early cosmos looked like, especially before the first stars appeared. So, where do we go from here? Astronomers are currently developing a new set of space and ground-based telescopes, as well as smaller-scale equipment and research. They intend to use these techniques to investigate dark matter and dark energy, black holes at the centers of galaxies, the development of planets such as Earth around other stars, and many other features of our amazing universe. Well, now you know how the universe formed from nothing. If you found this video useful, help us out by giving it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for our next video.